Hello everybody, ready for our next chart? We're going to look at the average order size. And maybe you remember from last week that there are three basic charts. We have a bar chart or a column chart, we have a line chart, and we have a scatter. The scatter you won't see in the dashboard. And the reason is that this is a business dashboard, and normally we do not use a scatter plot a lot because we do not have to explain relations between objects. Between variables. So we started with the bar chart, and now we go to the next basic chart, which is the column chart. And it's going to be the average order size. And I will take a short moment to look at the x-axis. There we see the periods, and the periods consist of 2015-06 to 2016-06. And there are two things notable, that you do not need to repeat for every label the year. If you start with the year and if you end with the year, it's very clear for the reader that these are months in a year. And you save a little bit space, because what I don't want to see is text that is vertical aligned or that is rotated. I just want to have normal plain text. The second thing you see is, if you ask people to make some kind of trend overview, they normally will select 12 periods, because that's a whole year. What I did over here, and what I did in every trend chart in the dashboard, is I selected 30 months. And the reason that I do that is that if I choose 30 months, I can compare this year with last year. And that's what you see in the chart. You see 2016-06, and we can compare it with 2015-06. So that's a small tip. Use 13 periods. Now, let's see how we can create that ourselves in Excel. We need to have the average order size. Here is the raw data. And just a very quick moment, because what you remember maybe from the chart is that the 2015-06, there was a hard return in it. And this is the way how you do it. I have the year. I have the month, and in between I put character 13, which is a hard return, and that makes it possible to get the year on one row and the period on the other row. The rest is easy. So here I have my data, and I want to have my average order size. So I'm going to select that. And my normal strategy for creating a chart is just select the data and then insert the graph or the chart. And in this case, I want to have a column chart. Again, 2D. And here it is. And I made a little mistake, so we're going to delete that, because it would be nice if we instruct Excel what should be on the x-axis. That should be the periods. And then I use the control button again. And the control button is playing tricks with me today. There it is. So now I have the two ranges, one for the x-axis and one for the average order size. I say insert, column chart, column, and there we are. And I see that now I have a nice x-axis. First thing that I notice is I have my title again. I will remove it. I still don't like the white space, so we're going to change that to 75%. And actually what I should have done also on the other chart is I should make it a little bit smaller, because we really have to fight for space on our dashboard. So normally I make it 8 points. I don't need the grid lines. And I don't want to have a fill. So most of the times we're changing the same things. don't want to have a fill, and to be sure I don't want to have a border, because sometimes if I leave it on automatic, Excel will edit. Now I still remember the dimensions of my chart, so I'm going to change them. They were 2.15 by 2.27, and it should be the right format. Now it's still a bit crowded over here in the x-axis, so what I could do is, so I selected it, I can check that I selected it over here, and now I can say I want to have my labels on a specific interval, which is 3, which makes it less crowdy. And I think I'm quite happy now with my chart, so I'm going to copy it, go back to my dashboard, and it can go next to our previous chart. We will specify that it is, the order size is in 1 times $1, and we have to say this is the average order size. There we are. Okay, so that was the average order size. So we have the sales by category, we have the average order size, we have two of our charts, but you see we have still a lot of empty white spaces. And in the next video, we're going to have a look at a sales trend. We're going to have a new chart type. See you then.